concept of relative angular speed. So suppose two particles are moving in a circle or different coplanar concentric circles in the same direction with uniform angular speed omega A and omega B respectively, then the angular velocity of B relative to A will be omega relative is equal to omega B minus omega A. So first we will take a circular path in which two objects are moving. This is our object A and this is our object B. Now object A is moving with angular speed omega A and object B is moving with angular speed omega B. So the relative angular speed of B with respect to A will be given by omega relative omega B minus omega A. That is, suppose I put omega A is equal to 3 radian per second and omega B is equal to 5 radian per second. So it means in 1 second omega B will move 2 radians more than omega 2 radians more than the particle A. So it will move a bit faster and it will cover the circle in less time in comparison to particle A. So now we will calculate the time in which particle B completes one revolution more than the particle A. As the omega B is greater than omega A, so the particle B will complete one revolution in less time than A. And this time will be given by T is equal to 2 pi by omega relative. Means we have to calculate the time taken by B in which B completes one revolution more than particle A in this circular path. So exactly if the B covers one revolution more than the particle A in this circular path, then suppose in the time T A covers revolutions and come to this point, during this time B covers one more revolution than the A. So B covers 2 pi more angle than the A with the difference equal to these two angular speed. Now if the B completes one revolution more than particle A, then it will cover a angular displacement equal to 2 pi more than A. And this angular displacement 2 pi will be covered with the extra angular speed of omega B minus omega A. In the 1 second, it will cover a difference equal to 1 second, it covers a extra difference equal to 2 radian. So to cover a net angular displacement of 2 pi, it will take time is equal to 2 pi divided by 2 radian per second. So this is the time taken by object B to cover one more revolution than A. So we may write this to equal to T is equal to 2 pi by omega relative. That is, with the angular speed omega relative, it will cover more angular displacement with respect to particle A. So that's why I have written time T is equal to 2 pi by omega relative and it is equal to 2 pi divided by omega 2 minus omega 1. Now as we know that time T is equal to 2 pi by omega, so if I put the value of omega is equal to 2 pi by T, then this value will be changed to omega divided by 2 pi by T2 minus 2 pi by T1 and it is equal to 2 pi divided by 2 pi 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1 and it is equal to T1 into T2 divided by T1 minus T2. So time in which B completes one revolution more than A will be given by T1 T2 divided by t1 minus t2. So if the problem will be given in such a way that the angular speed of B will be 5 radian per second, angular speed of A will be 3 radian per second, then you have to calculate the time in which B completes one more revolution around O than A, then you will just apply the formula T is equal to 2 pi by 2 second or pi second. Suppose instead of angular speed, if the time taken or the time period of both will be given, that is, if it is given that TA is equal to we may say 7 second and TB is equal to 5 second, then you have to calculate the time in which B will complete one more revolution around A than A. Because B will take less time to complete one revolution, so B will cover more revolution in the same time. So time taken to complete one revolution more than A will be given by 7 into 5 divided by 7 minus 5, and comes equal to 35 by 2. So these two formula are very handy, and by using this formula you can get idea of relative angular speed. Now we will consider some special case when angular speed of B is equal to angular speed of A, that is, both particle are moving in the circle with the same angular speed, like A is moving with angular speed of 3 radian per second and B is also moving with angular speed of 3 radian per second. So whenever they will be able to means make more revolution than each other, is it possible? No. So we may say that the omega relative or the relative angular speed will be zero, or the time t is equal to infinite. So both particle will maintain their position relative to each other. Suppose at time t is equal to 0, both particle is at same point, then at any instant of time, both particle will be at the will be close to each other or at the same location. But suppose at time t is equal to 0, A is at point, the particle A is at this point and particle B is diametrically opposite to A, and both are moving with angular speed 3 radian per second. 3 radian per second. So 3 and 3. So so in this way, at any instant of time, these two particles will be diametrically opposite to each other, or they maintain their position relative to each other. So at some instant of time, if A will be there, then B will be at this instant will be at this point, just diametrically opposite to A. If A will be at this point, then B will be diametrically opposite to A. So we may write that omega relative in this case is equal to zero, and this is actually happens in case of geostationary satellite. So in case of geostationary satellite, the angular speed of Earth and angular speed of satellite both will be same. That is, omega 1 is equal to omega 2 and it is equal to constant. So now we learn the concept of geostationary satellite. We will just briefly understand what is this geostationary satellite. So a geostationary satellite is an Earth orbiting satellite placed at an altitude of approximately 35,800 kilometer, that is 22,300 miles. So this is the distance at which geostationary Earth orbiting satellite will be placed directly over the equator that revolves in the same direction the Earth rotates. So as we know that Earth rotates west to east, so geostationary satellite will also rotate west to east, and the time taken by geostationary satellite is same to complete one revolution, same as the time taken by Earth to complete one revolution. That is, at this altitude, one orbit takes 24 hours. So, time taken by geostationary satellite to cover one rotation along its axis or along this circle will be same as the time taken by Earth to complete one rotation. So because of this, the geostationary satellite appears nearly stationary in the sky as seen by ground-based observer. So these two these facts you just keep in your mind, that geostationary satellites takes 24 hours to complete one revolution. It is placed at altitude of 35,800 kilometer or 22,300 miles directly over equator and revolves in same direction the Earth rotates, that is west to east.